At this time, everybody with an office job is asking the same question. Am I really going to be replaced with artificial intelligence? Are machines going to destroy my career? As we delve into the realm of architecture and AI, we're not just exploring technology, we're exploring the very essence of creativity and human integrity. This will not be a fear-mongering video, but rather a video about the forefront of innovation where the future meets the present and where the question isn't whether AI will replace us, but how will it inspire us to reach new heights. Today's tool of choice is Verus AI, an AI software by Evolve Lab. This is an AI-powered rendering engine that uses Revit models to generate renderings with the help of prompts. You simply need to select a view, pick one of the preset options, or create your own, and click render. You will get a rendering in less than 30 seconds on average. Then it's just a matter of modifying the prompts or selecting the areas to change in order to get the perfect result. This video is not sponsored, and it will be an honest review. Speaking of AI, if you go to balkanarchitect.com, you can find a completely new course exactly on this topic, AI for architecture and interior design. To get this course, follow the first link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. And in this video, you will notice that I'm going to be using some new projects, and these projects are actually part of my completely new beginner to intermediate level course, which will be released really soon. And if you have the existing one, well, you will get the update completely for free. Now, because this new beginner to intermediate course will be slightly more expensive, it makes sense to get the existing one now and then get the update completely for free. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. Now, before we continue, let me just exchange my futuristic AI cyberpunk glasses for the ones that actually help me see. And now let's start rendering. So here I have picked out a view that I want to render of this beautiful house. So when you install Verus AI, it's going to appear like this, like the Evolve Lab tab. And then when you click on that, we have Verus AI. You just click on start and it's going to open up a window. Now I'm just going to make this a bit smaller so I can see it on the screen. And the first thing that we have is the Explore page, and this is really simple. You see the image that you're rendering, and then here we have some 9 presets, and we can also customize the width and the height of the image. In this case, I'm just going to increase the width a little bit, and then perhaps the height a bit. Yeah, I think this will work. And then I can pick out one of these presets. So let's say I want to go with this one. I think the Winter Cabin creative, it's going to give me the best results, and then I can just hit render. And now after about 26 seconds, this is the result that we get, and it looks really cool. Now, once you get the first rendering, you're going to notice that here these three buttons are now available. The first one is the option to save, of course. Then we have the preview toggle, so we can show the view in Revit, and then we can toggle back to rendering. And we also have the refresh button. So basically, if you change anything in Revit, so if you change the view angle or something like that, well, you can just refresh that view here in Verus AI as well. Now, let's go to the Compose tab, and this is where your prompt skills are really going to come to shine. So if I just cancel out of here, here we have the geometry override, basically how much do you want to allow Verus AI to change the actual geometry of your building. Then we have the material override, how much are you willing to change the materials. And then we have the width and height of the image. And here we have some basic presets. So do you want this to render as an interior or as an aerial view? I'm guessing sometime for a top-down bird's perspective. Then we have turbo nature and atmospheric. We're going to be looking into these. And then we also have the prompts, which you can place here, and the prompt strength. So how important these prompts are and how extreme do you want Verus AI to be with them. So now let's try something. So I'm just going to keep the geometry override at something a bit smaller. Let's keep the material override on. And then here I'm just going to say, let's say modern design concrete house. And now let's hit render and see what we get. And now it's done. So we have the second rendering here. If I open it up, and as you can see, this one took a bit longer. However, this is the result. Now we have some weird kind of background concrete happening here, but overall the house looks quite interesting. And as you can see, yeah, the material override is really, really strong. Now let's try turning on the turbo nature and keep the same prompts as is. And also one more thing to mention is this speed option. So you can check this on and then you can kind of define speed, but usually I just like to keep it at automatic. So now let's hit render and see what we get. And the result is, well, this. So with turbo nature, we get, well, more nature, and I really like the way that it turned out. And also let's try atmospheric. So let's see what that would look like. And I'm just going to turn off the turbo nature and let's render this again. And this is what we get. So turbo nature, in this case, a lot of fog, but I think this looks really, really cool. Let's make it a clown house. So modern design, concrete clown house, and hit render. And here we have the result. So not much in the way of clowns. However, it looks even more impressive. So I really like it. So as you can see, these are some of the basics in terms of how we can use prompts and all of these settings in order to get different results. Now we also have the refine page here. So what the refine page allows you to do is basically sketch out which part of this you want to refine, and then you can do it. So what I can do here is I can just start drawing a shape. So let's select this wall that we have here, just like that. And then I'm going to go to prompt and then say green wall, and then let's hit render. And now let's take a look at the result. And this is the result. As you can see, it has rendered this, and now we have this green wall. I can hit the escape key here. And this is what we had before. This is what we have now. And yeah, this is how you can basically refine certain parts of your renderings where you want to make some specific changes. This is how you do it. Now let's cover some tips for working. It's really important to understand how AI is thinking so we can lead it in the right direction. At first, I was relying on the text prompts a bit too much, thinking that AI will read my mind somehow. But in time, I realized that the images that we provide from Revit are as much of a prompt as those text prompts. In a way, the images from Revit are the most important prompt that we provide the AI. For Veros AI, the geometry type and visual style are really important and should be considered a type of a prompt. So now let's go through some examples of different prompts in terms of images and what we get as a result. So the first one that I have here is a simple mass with no building geometry. As you can see here, if I do just a little bit of a material override, we really get nothing. And if we completely override the materials, we get something. However, it's not really anything that we can actually use. Moving forward to a mass with just blank walls and roofs applied. So it's basically the same mass with just a little bit of geometry. And as you can see, with no material override, we get really nothing. And then with a lot of material override, we get something. It's starting to look okay. We're going in the right direction. However, we're still not getting that much. So without the doors and windows, you're not really going to be able to achieve a good result. Moving forward to an actual complete building model with the hidden line visual style, we're really starting to get somewhere. So as you can see, with no material override, it's not much. However, if we do apply some material override, we are going to get a really interesting and nice result. Taking it a step further and going with a clay model, a realistic clay model, meaning all of the materials are white apart from glass, which is just transparent. With no material override, it actually looks kind of worse. However, if we do apply the material override, we're getting to something that looks like this. Again, something a lot more interesting. Then we have a realistic model with materials applied. And those materials I would consider a type of a prompt. And now we're getting something that looks a lot more interesting, especially the last one with this turbo nature and atmospheric checked on. It's going to look really, really interesting. And finally, in the last example, I have the same house, the same materials. However, this is a rendering and not a realistic view. And as you can see, the results are pretty much the same as with the realistic visual style. So going between realistic and a rendering, I think it really doesn't matter. You're going to get the same results. So it doesn't make any sense to waste time rendering in Revit when the Verus AI will give you the same result. Now, for all of these examples, one really important thing to note is the shadows. So in some of these, I had shadows turned on, and in some of those, I had shadows turned off. And what I've noticed is that sometimes Verus AI will pick up shadows as different materials or as geometry or something like that. So I would suggest avoiding having shadows turned on just because I think it's going to give you better results if they're turned off, and it's not going to confuse the AI thinking that you have a different material applied or something like that. You can see here in this zone, it's kind of confused. Should this be the whole wall in the same material, or are you trying to do kind of a diagonal line with different materials? So best practice, just keep the shadows off at all times when rendering with Verus AI. Now, continuing on this theme of using model elements as prompts and using your Revit model as a prompt, getting Verus AI to generate a surroundings that look exactly how you want them to look can be really difficult if you rely on prompts alone. So what they've started doing is including model elements as prompts. For example, as you can see here from this image, if I say, okay, I want some trees in the back, I want some nice cars in the front, I want people in the front, it's really going to give me a confusing image. It tends to start placing cars on upper levels of this building, which I don't want. And then here we have some, it just looks like cars going really fast, and yeah, not the best result. So anyways, trying with just prompts doesn't give me the best result. However, when I tried placing RPC trees, RPC people, RPC cars, so it's those kind of weird Revit families that we have. So I just placed those in a rendering, and then as a prompt to Verus AI, I would say, okay, so I want some luxury cars, I want some oak trees, I want some business people. It did really figure out that those are the cars in front and the people and the trees, and the results were way better. Now, it doesn't really follow the same positioning of those cars and people. However, it does look way better than just having no people and no cars and no trees and asking for the same result. So just try adding whatever you want to use as the context, as the surroundings, and you're going to get way better results. And then you can just use prompts in order to kind of suggest what this should be. So you can place any car and then say, okay, I want an interesting red truck or something like that. And it can figure out that the car should be there. But without that car in the actual model, it might not give you the result that you're looking for. So what's my final verdict? Well, coming into this, I apologize. Much better. Coming into this with all of the AI-related hype and prejudice, I thought, well, this is just going to replace architecture visualization professionals. Looking at it now, I'm sure that those impressive photorealistic renderings will still have to be done by humans for some time in the future. The part of the workflow that Verus AI does replace is creating test renderings to test design ideas like adding different materials or similar. This could take an hour or so on a complex project, and here it's just a matter of entering a few prompts and you're done. Also, for some middle-of-the-road client presentation, I think these renderings would be perfect to help the client see the vision for the final project. Mainly, as with the text AI tools like ChatGPT, I see this as an extremely powerful brainstorming tool for architects and interior designers. The ideas that Verus AI generated sometimes were something that I considered an annoying mistake. But other times, they were genius ideas for my designs. For example, on this interior design project, not once did I think about painting this wall gray, but Verus AI introduced this idea and now we're seriously considering it. Overall, I'm really impressed and my team and I will continue to use it in our brainstorming sessions and perhaps for generating some thumbnails, B-roll images, and so on. And I'm extremely interested in hearing what you have to say. Have you tested out Verus AI or any other AI tools for architects? Please tell me in the comment section below what do you think about Verus AI, and also if you have any other tools that you would recommend that I review, that you would like to see a video, yeah, please tell me that in the comment section below. And of course, if you want to get access to all of these project files that they have shown in this video, all of my Revit project files are available on my Patreon page. The link is going to be up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.